give me four tacos. You can give me this day. Four tacos a day.
Up the blind side, Connie Powell goes straight over the tackler. Irwin, the pick and go, Green right on her shoulder, gives it short to Vicky Irwin again. Watts spreading the play, Abidal coming in, great step from Abidal. Under the stick! Decent chance here for Bristol Bears for the try that'll take them to the playoffs! Robinson goes, Detivo one-on-one to score! On her outside, steps again, magical from Helena Rowland. Vivat now, short to Marley Packer, runs up against Beckett, spins, goes again, brilliant from Packer.
They are the 2022 Allianz Premier 15's champions.
Good afternoon and welcome to, well, a bitterly cold StoneX Stadium for Saracens women against University of Worcester Warriors women. We've taken refuge from that cold here in the W Club, and I'm delighted to say that I'm joined this afternoon by Donna Rose. Donna, it's fantastic to have you with us, and it should be a really, really exciting match today.
Yeah, playing Worcester is always exciting. You never know what they're going to come with, so I'm excited to watch.
Worcester have had their troubles off the field this season, linked to the men's club, but 3 wins from 6, and Joe Yap's building something really, really special there.
Yeah, I respect all the players for staying strong, and I think it's built them nicely all together, come together as a team. I think, you know, fair play to them, and good luck to them.
They've got a giant killing of their own already this season, Harlequins away in the opening round. What are going to be the key things that Saracens have to focus on today to avoid a result like that?
I think not letting them to exploit out wide. They've got threatening wingers. You know, their maul is good. We need to get low and protect it.
You were talking to me a little bit earlier about some of the impact off the bench as well. Karis Phillips, a player you know well, a hat-trick last week, but an impact player today for them.
Yeah, with stats like hers, I'm surprised she is sitting on the bench. But whatever number shirt she has, she's going to come on and absolutely be amazing. So fair play to her with the stats, tries, you know. It's great to play with her, rubbish to play against her. But
what of Saracens then? Because it's not been a typical Saracens start to the season. 3 wins from 6, sitting 6th in the table. But Alex Austerbury said to the press in the week, there's no need to put the button down yet, put that panic button down yet.
Absolutely not. I don't think we should panic as of yet. We train and we play the Saracens way. Unfortunately, the last couple of weeks, it's been a bit down, it's been cold, you know, and it's not really been we've not really been ourselves, but I absolutely believe from now on, you know, we've had that little kick, Alex's size 5 feet. So yeah, I think we're ready to go to bring back the Saracens way.
And there's still 12 games to go. That's the thing I think everybody's forgetting here. Tons of time left and starting to get today against Worcester. But there does need to be a response after that extra performance last weekend.
Absolutely. Last weekend, all the girls were, you know, upset but more disappointed in themselves. We didn't play how we normally play. We didn't have the go forward. But this game, we're going to make it right.
Being back at the StoneX as well, I suppose, always helps.
Absolutely, especially with our fans.
Well, the fans are fantastic. We've got a good number of them coming in today as well. But these live streams simply would not be possible without our wonderful partners here at Saracens. And we just wanted to take a moment to say thank you to them.
An unprecedented market force is causing a shift in direction. There may be some long-term opportunity if traders can see through the noise.
Master the market forces with City Index. Trade with confidence.
We're only here to make you, we're only here to make you, we're only here.
We're still here in the W Club, fantastic hospitality here in the amazing tunnel at StoneX Stadium, and as the lights go down around us, as will happen before kickoff, you really get a sense of the atmosphere for the players as they prepare themselves to run out. Donna, I suppose a bit of a difficult one, you've not had a chance to run out through this yet this season, but it really does create a brilliant atmosphere for the players.
Absolutely. You know, I've been on the end of there and I've given them a clap as they're running through, and even I feel the buzz, you know, through these lights, through people watching down the corridor here, to our fans. It's fantastic atmosphere, and I can't wait myself to get onto it.
Speaking of the fans then, have been turning up in their droves so far this season, but 18th of February, the duel against Harlequins, London's biggest rivalry as it's been marketed this year, going to be some occasion, and I suppose revenge is on everyone's minds.
Yeah, definitely. It didn't go our way when we went down to them, didn't go their way in the final. This is why it's a bit of a rivalry, I think. It's to and fro, it's never, you know, one club's beating the other by, you know, three or four times. It's back and forth, and that's what's exciting about the duel. So I definitely think people should come and watch. It's going to be an exciting game for both clubs. Hopefully Saracens get the win.
So many new faces as well for both sides this season, and like you said, that 19-10 victory for Harlequins earlier in the season. 18th of Feb, two fully stacked teams and some brilliant individual battles. You've got Jess Breach versus Abby Dow, you've got the Cleals going up against each other, and like you said, a brilliant day out for the fans.
Yeah, absolutely. Their pack, our pack, going against each other. It's like a pack of rhinos against a pack of rhinos, isn't it? Releasing their backs to, you know, releasing our backs. It's going to be a show. It's going to be a showdown.
It will be a fantastic show. There's some brilliant hospitality packages on offer for the duel as well on the Saracens website, and tickets for just £10. If you've not got yours yet, why haven't you, first of all? But if you haven't, here's a little taster of what's in store for you on the 18th of February.
The duel.
Saracens women versus Harlequins women. 2 p.m. Saturday, February 18th.
StoneX Stadium.
Tickets on sale now.
Don't miss it.
Well, I tell you what, that promo video there has certainly got me excited for the duel. Can't wait for that one. Donna, just focusing on that rivalry with Quins a little bit more. You said about those rivalries over the years in the finals, but the semi-final last season, over 2,000 people here at StoneX. Probably one of the best atmospheres we've had for a women's game here.
Yeah, we all know Quins have a great fan base. We have a great fan base. And everyone brought it that day. The hearing our crowds and their crowd really go at it, that was something special. I played in that game, and it really did give us that extra 10% that we needed, and that's a game to be proud of, that.
And I suppose a bit of revenge for Quins beating Saris in the final the year before to knock them out in the semi-finals in front of, like you said, an absolutely raucous crowd.
Yeah, I played that one too. That wasn't a nice game at the end. Yeah, again, great game to watch, not to play. I think I was battered after that game. But yeah, it's a great rivalry. If you haven't got your tickets, get it, because we never know what's going to happen.
The duel, like you said, is going to be a fantastic occasion, but a couple of people that will hope they can keep that control on the day will be Amy Turner at Harlequins, Alex Austerbury here at Saracens. That coaching unit of himself, Lewis Soanes, Juan Figalo, James Tyrrell, they're so integral to everything that happens here at the club.
Yeah, I think it's fantastic that we have a root at this club. You know, like Alex Austerbury, like you just said, he's been here years. Lewis, you know, he does academy and work with the kids and stuff. I just think it's great that we keep that root, and I think that leads to success. like our players, Zoe, Marley, Poppy, you know, they've all been here, they're all 100 plus caps, and that shows on the field. We all connect, we all get on, and yeah, that's the route.
Well, as we said, Alex Austria will be hoping to keep control over things on the pitch this afternoon at the Jewel as well. But how good was he at completing a series of challenges alongside Rocky Clark and Juan Fagallo? Let's have a look.
Oh, this could take a while.
Then what?
Set
of
ice.
Oh, that's... Oh. So now? Who uses chopsticks to do dice? This ain't very good, is it? I'm not very dexterous.
Oh my god!
I'm not good at this.
Oh!
I used them. Oh, this could take a while. How long's the record for the longest time? What's next? Is that it?
Good thing that Alex Austria and Juan Fagallo are outstanding coaches, isn't it? There's a couple of bits in that VT they probably won't want to be seeing again in a hurry. It's a really important day for the team in terms of getting points on the board against Worcester, but for two individuals as well, and two players you know really well. Kelsey Clifford, 50th appearance for the club. May Campbell, her 100th appearance for the club. Just how integral are they to everything that happens here?
Kelsey Clifford, wow. I mean, she's 21, she's got 50 caps for Saracens in the Premiership. She's got years to go yet, and she is a strong ball carrier. You know, she's strong in the pack, and I'm excited to see her future.
And May as well, 100 caps, probably near enough 100 tries in a Saracens career as well. Seems to score one or two a game, but been here six or seven seasons now, and again, just absolutely integral to that front row.
You've took my joke there. I was going to say she's probably doubled them caps with tries. Yeah, absolutely. May performs every game. You know, she runs out, she makes the hits. You know, she's always on the end of the balls. Sticky hands May, I call her. She's always the try scorer, you know. Head pops up, it's always May Campbell. So congratulations to them two on their caps. It's amazing.
Fantastic day for the pair of them today as well. And we spoke to May Campbell a little bit earlier in the week to go through some of her memories from her previous 99 games and what she's looking forward to improving on and working on in hopefully the next 100.
Yeah, massively important. We obviously let ourselves down last weekend, and we can only now learn from that and look forward to this weekend against Worcester. Yeah, I'm hugely proud to reach that milestone. Over the last seven seasons, I've loved playing here. It's been tough at times, but the group of girls and coaching staff have been incredible. Definitely the finals that I've been part of, the one where we played Franklin Gardens, that was very memorable, and obviously last year's as well, at Worcester, playing against Chiefs, that was a great day. Yeah, it's been great to see how the game has grown in the level of professionalism. Obviously a brand new stand here at StoneX, but then also from paying your membership fee to now what we have in place and being able to play amongst international and professional players I'm just grateful to be part of the environment. I think hopefully trying to like push on my game as much as possible, improving. I know obviously throwing is a sort of weakness of mine, so getting that to where it ought to be, and yeah, just I'm excited to see where everyone and the coaches can push my game to get.
Well, Donna May said there that she wants to improve her throwing in the next 100 or so caps for the club. She's actually got the best line-out success rate this season in the league, but there you go, always striving to improve, and you surely think international honours are going to follow the way she keeps challenging herself to improve every game.
I think it's a battle between England and Scotland who's going to get her to cap first. She's fantastic. She's great to work with as well.
Brilliant player to work with, as you said, a brilliant player to play with, I'm sure, and a wonderful player to coach. Let's find out what Director of Rugby Alex Horsbury had to say ahead of this one. But first, Worcester Warriors Director of Rugby Joe Yap.
Joe, really good victory last week against DMP. You're currently sat in fifth place in the table. How pleased have you been with the start to the season, with everything that's been going on in the background?
Look, yeah, we're really pleased. The girls have shown so much resilience this season. Like you say, there's been so much off-field stuff to deal with. So we've been trying to just control the controllables, focus on the on-pitch stuff. But inevitably, yes, it does have an impact on players. Like emotionally, it's been tough. But yeah, they keep stepping up, so we're really proud of them.
Talk about that pride there. Obviously, immense pride at the start of the season with that victory away against Harlequins. Your side have shown that they're not afraid to come to the perceived bigger clubs in the league that have been in the knockout stages before and really show what they can do.
No, and that's a challenge for us, because in the past, like Worcester have sat at the bottom, and you know, 3 years ago they were on the back of some big defeats, and it's trying to change that mindset and actually have that belief that we can come to sides like Saracens and Quins and actually like put in performances and get results, and that's the belief we're trying to instill in the squad.
The last couple of visits you've had here to the StoneX, not quite come out on the right side of the result, but they've been really high scoring, tight matches. What have you asked your side to do today to try and get on the right side of a result like that?
Well, last week the girls played some really good attacking rugby up against DMP, and we just need to have that same mindset against Saracens. Like, I think it's obviously very easy, isn't it, to look at the Saracens team and see the likes of Marley Packer and Poppy, and it's, you know, they're a tough opposition, but actually have that belief to take them on and to attack and to move the ball like we know that they can and like we see in training.
Brilliant. Well, Joe, best of luck this afternoon. Alex, a disappointing result last week away at Exeter, but a big week of training and a chance to put a lot of things right today, you'd imagine.
Yeah, absolutely. No, it was, the result was a reflection of the performance, so it was the performance elements that were disappointing. We've had to have a real kind of clarity and refocus on what is it we need to do, getting back to our standards, which we fell short of. So ultimately, yeah, there's nothing better than getting out the next week to try put things right.
You said to the press this week that obviously sixth place isn't a place you're used to being, but it's about performances at the moment and those results will follow. I suppose that's going to be the target now, building into this block of games.
Yeah, look, you can't look at the big picture. You've got to sort out the stuff that's right in front of you, the immediacy of it. Obviously the big picture is important, but right now it's about getting back to our standards, getting back to playing with our identity, our level of intensity and physicality, and then from that we'll start to build the momentum, because it's been a bit fractured to this point.
Zoe Harrison back in at 10 today as well. How important is it to be able to pick from a pretty much full squad again now?
We've still got quite a few players out. We've got Fleeto warming up behind us, obviously Botts, Donna Rose, and that's just to name a few. But to have the quality of players available to us is always very important. And you know, we're getting there. Now we just need to get up to speed and make sure again that whoever's wearing the shirt 1 through to 23 are ready to put in a performance, reflects the sum of the parts, and that we absolutely maximise what we're capable of doing.
The final one as well. Two stalwarts despite their tender ages, getting huge milestones for you today. Kelsey's 50th, May's 100th. How proud are you of what they've achieved in the Saracens shirt so far?
So I think that's the important thing so far. I mean, to get to this stage in relatively young ages is fantastic. The level of commitment, you know, the level of performance that they've both displayed. But I think the most exciting thing for me as a coach is that this is, you know, it's not the beginning, but it certainly isn't the culmination of what they're capable of doing. So it's a milestone on hopefully to go on great, to, you know, achieve greater things in a Saracen shirt, and more importantly, drive us on to be even more successful.
Brilliant. Well, Alex, fingers crossed they can bring that success for you today, and best of luck.
Thank you.
Yeah. 901 Shelby Drive, look alive, look alive. Came up on this side, now they on the other side. Oh well, them dog, we gon' see how hard they ride. I get racks to go outside and I split it with the guys. We up on the other side, that then like we tied. I've been gone since late July, that then like I died. They won't be expecting when Kappa go to slide. Cause I told them that we put that behind us, but I lied. Ayy. Look who I'm around, man. If I f***ed up, I'ma be downtown, man. Four flow down, man. That's if I get caught, man. Push me to the edge, so it really ain't my fault, man. I'm not to blame, man. This industry is cut, though I'm not the same, man. And I can let you check the tag, man.
Well, thank you very much. Here we are then at StoneX Stadium. Saw there from that VT just how up for it this Saracen side are today. Good crowd in again here with kickoff building up. And let's have a look through the Saracens team. Then a couple of changes from last week against Exeter Chiefs. Mackenzie Carson, first start of the season at Loosehead. Georgia Evans back in the starting side at blindside flanker. Ella Viervas and Zoe Harrison returning at 9 and 10 respectively, and Corrine Grant coming in on the right wing for Jess Breach, who drops to the bench alongside Alex Ellis, Grace Moore and Leanne Infante. And looking at the University of Worcester Warriors side then, packed with experience but packed with exciting talent as well. Flo Long actually had one game on loan for Saracens at the start of the season in the Premiership Cup, so she'll be eager to prove what she can do today alongside Carmen Tremling and Lana Skeldon, a whole new front row after last week's victory over DMP. A late change in the back row as well. Alex Callender was due to start but was ruled out yesterday evening. Joe Brown comes in at number 8 and Cara Brinkett comes in on the blind side. It's Katie Mattinson as co-captain alongside Skeldon, and Abby Kershaw joining her at fly half. Watch out for that back three as well of Paige Farries, Lydia Thompson and Kat McNanay, who are absolutely rapid when they get going. Donna, it's two really, really exciting lineups today, and Lottie Clapp against Lydia Thompson, the experience there going head to head will be really, really entertaining.
Yeah, I can't wait to see that foot race happen today. Let's have it. I'm excited for this.
Talk about that excitement. The excitement's going through the roof here for everybody. And some really nice touches here today at StoneX Stadium as well. Fantastic crowd in attendance, as we said. I can see some oddballs hats there from Hitchin RFC. And Old Alanians, Fee McIntosh's old club, are today's flag wavers for us in the tunnel. And Donna, we talk about it all the time, but it's so good to have, as we see the flag wavers now, have these young players coming down, seeing game days and experiences like this, and being able to be a part of it as well.
Absolutely. I think it means so much to them, and it means so much to us to have them there. Their support is amazing, and I look forward to see some of them on the TV when they get older.
Well, hopefully for the Old Alanians players that are here today, they will be following in Fee McIntosh's footsteps in just a few years' time. And as you see them there waving their flags, we've also got three fantastic mascots here today as well. And they will be coming out with Lottie Clapp and Marley Packer, but obviously Mae Campbell, Kelsey Clifford front and centre today as they run out. But they want today to be all about the team. They won't want to focus on themselves too much.
I would focus on me, to be honest.
you might. I'm not sure their characters are quite like that, Donna, but either way, it should be a really, really good one. We talked about it in that build-up. May Campbell, Kelsey Clifford, they're still so young in comparison to be hitting those numbers for the club.
I'm so excited to see Kelsey go today on her 50 if she's only borrowing my shirt.
You want it back at the end. You want it back sooner or later, there's no doubt. Just whilst we're on that, how are you progressing with everything?
I'm 5 weeks in now of my knee operation, and it's going well. My ACL's nice and strong now. Just got to get my muscles up and running again, and I'll be back.
Well, here come Worcester Warriors out onto the field then. Lana Skeldon leading her side out. And they will be ready for this one, no doubt. Joe Yap saying their pre-match, yes, they've had that giant killing already this season against Harlequins in round one, but it's very much a case of progressing and improving as a collective team. And here we go
here
then.
Here they come.
Here they come, as you say, Donna. May Campbell running out for her 100th appearance. Kelsey Clifford behind her for her 50th. And here comes Lottie Clapp and Marley Packer leading out the rest of the side. And as they come out and through and hear that roar of the crowd and get ready to hit the tackle bags, May Campbell there, she looks up for this one.
So proud of them both. They both worked extremely hard, especially Kelsey, being young and coming in. She's really fighting for that shirt, and she deserves to start at number three today.
Kelsey Clifford's been starting at loose head most times this season with Alex Ellis at tight head, but a bit of a switch around today to bring Mackenzie Carson into the side. And as Saracens do their last warm-ups, hitting those tackle pads, getting themselves ready, the roar from the crowd, the roar from the PA system as well. Hollywood, our referee today, Chris Bartlett, Fiona Brunt, assistant referees. It'll be Zoe Harrison who gets us underway for this one. Hollywood, experienced referee. Zoe Harrison, experienced fly half. I think that goes without saying. And there we go then, underway here at StoneX Stadium. That one goes long from Harrison, taken well on that far side by Worcester. Lydia Thompson, an early touch for her. And Mattinson just steadies herself, readying herself for a first long booming clearance kick. And that one taken well by Veervas. And there's McKenna, first touch for the fullback. A nice offload to Veervas, and Veervas goes hunting, gets the hands free. Brilliant run there. And there's Mackenzie Carson into Fee McIntosh. Brilliant interplay. May Campbell still going. 5 metres out, Saracens already. An advantage coming as well. And Harrison takes it herself. Nearly through the gap, Zoe Harrison, but the penalty advantage still there. And now the forwards in where they want to be. Poppy Cleal taking control.
This is where our power players should step up now and get over that line.
Let's see what Saracens can do then. They're hunting. No advantage coming though as Kelsey Clifford looked to go towards the line. But we'll come back for that penalty. 5 metres out from the Worcester line, and a really, really good start there from Saracens, and the hands working really well, especially after last week.
5 metres over there or here.
Okay. Yeah, it's great to see that we're getting it out and getting them offloads to our powerful forwards.
Nine,
and taking
never
it
on side.
Saracens then going to the corner with this one. Well, they've changed their minds. They were going to go for the corner instead. They're going for the quick tap. A clever play in and around, and a try.
No doubt, no doubt. She's getting that line there. Kelsey Clifford scoring on her 50th cap. Well done. There's no doubt she was getting over there with her power and speed coming onto that ball.
Fantastic play there, and we've seen it so many times already this season, the men's game and the women's game. Some real ingenuity around those quick tap penalties 5 metres out, and we saw it again from Saracens there, didn't we? That clever little wrap around the back from Cleal to Clifford to power over.
Yeah, it'd be good to see them brought back into the game. These driving balls are, it's a bit boring now, I reckon. Let's get them power players over.
sure you say it's a bit boring. May Campbell, I think, might disagree with you there. It's where she seems to get most of her tries. Harrison then, easy conversion, and it's 7-0 to Saracens, and a fantastic start after 2.5 minutes.
I only think it's boring because I never get the scores.
Well, your time will come, Donna, I'm sure. Worcester haven't really had a chance to touch the ball so far. And they're already setting themselves up for the restart. That one taken by Louise McMillan. How much good work has she done since arriving in the summer already, Louise McMillan? There's Georgia Evans back in a Saracen starting shirt today. And looking right up for this.
It's good to see Georgia back in a six shirt, to be honest. She's a back rower, but been playing in the second row. And even though I love having her behind me, she's a back rower, definitely.
Aitchison thought she might have been able to grab the ball there, if not for a slightly awkward bounce of the rugby ball. A clever kick in over the top from Worcester Warriors, fielded by Harrison, but advantage with the Warriors. And they'll come back for the penalty then. Offside, Saracens call there, and a really good opportunity, Donna, now for Worcester just to get into that Saracens half and try and build some phases.
Yeah, they've been getting their kicks through this season, so I think they will just be getting in on half. And I think, I'm excited for this. Let's see what they bring.
Okay, Sarah's on the end of the white.
Well, that's a decent nudge there. And Worcester are up towards that 22-metre line. And a first opportunity to see what they can do. Good first line out there. Mattison gets that one away to Hannah Bluck in the centres. And Worcester building the phases here, looking hungry, but then it's intercepted by Georgia Evans, but offside again, and another penalty for Worcester.
Just timing.
No doubt this one will go back into the corner and the Warriors will see what they are able to do. Again, from the line out.
Come on, penalty for you.
Decent nudge there into touch. 10 or 15 metres out.
Yeah. Okay, cool, thanks. You're here.
And Lana Skeldon then, she was absolutely on the money with that first dart. On the money again with the second, and now Worcester look to set the drive.
You're under pressure. Don't change four.
Saracens doing well to disrupt, but the Warriors away again, starting to make decent headway now. Poppy Cleal making a nuisance. It is brilliant defence, and Marley Packer's over the top there. Has she managed to get a turnover for her side? She has. Superb work from Packer, and there's May Campbell charging away. And Saracens then back to Harrison. Charge down though.
That was a great charge down.
Fantastic charge down. You can see those long levers there from... It was Cara Brinker getting herself up.
Take the
line. And putting good pressure on Harrison. And Worcester keeping Saracens where they want them at the moment.
I bet that hurt.
What one do you reckon hurt more? That one or Leanne Infante's charge down to the face last week?
Oh.
Good line out though from Saracens. And Harrison will have a second bite of the cherry here. That one much better. And Mattison, it goes through the legs and she has to chase it back. And Corinne Grant up there to make the tackle, but Mattison looks to get it away to Paige Farries. That one though has drifted forwards. And in the end, a really, really good escape from Saracens from a threatening position. Scrum time then, and let's see what happens here. Two packs going at it. Donna, when I did a game with Christian Judge earlier in the season, he laughed and said, let's be honest, everybody comes to watch the scrums. What's your take on it?
Yeah, I'm here watching the scrums. It's my thing.
Definitely your thing.
Both down this side.
Not Hollywood's thing though. They're not happy with how that one was set up. And it'll be a second opportunity for Olivia Vass to put the ball in.
just a shout out to Mackenzie here. This is a second or third game at Loosehead. Coming in and learning a new trade is tricky, as I came in from number eight. She's going to be a great number one.
Aiden.
We talk about those transitions between positions a lot in the women's game, but for Mackenzie Carson, like you said, a brilliant back row player, brilliant in open play as well, and showing that, well, looking at this scrum here, definitely showing what she can do in the front row. That ball then to Aitchison, inside ball to McKenna, but she stopped well originally. And Evans with the carry again. And again,
stop one. Okay, you're good.
Saracens happy to put boot to ball. Farries has that one just come off her fingertips. It has. She has to go chasing back.
Stop.
Clears herself,
wait,
but only
there.
Into the middle of the field. Picked up by Zoe Harrison. Now there is space on that left-hand side, and Harrison set off inside ball to Corinne Grant.
Hands away, Red.
Saracens making great headway now up to the 22 again. There's Georgia Evans. Olivia Vass then. May Campbell with the carry. Harrison and Lottie Clapp popping up in midfield, eventually just puts her head down, looks
backwards.
To get the offload away. It's gone backwards, but then it's fumbled on the floor and dived on by Mattison, and the opportunity for Saracens goes. Good hustle from Worcester. Flo Long there helping to protect the ball.
No, not again. Hold.
A decent nudge away, but again, only as far as Sarah McKenna. There is space. I can see you calling left, Donna. Let's see what happens. The kit's gone. It's just bobbled and round. And Harrison gets it away to Aitchison, who pops it inside to May Campbell. Not as clean as Saracens would have wanted. But they're still on the attack. And Georgia Evans wrapped up hard there in the contact by Abby Kershaw.
This defence by Worcester's great. They're coming off that line there.
Packer then shows, goes, there is space here.
Backwards!
The pass from Gregson just goes over the top of Kareen Grant's hands, and Worcester get that one away. You're right, Donna, unbelievable defence from Worcester, because Saracens were throwing everything they had at them there.
Saracens are more hungry this game. I think they've learnt their lesson. But Worcester had a good shift there.
You look at that kick through there from Sarah McKenna, just one bounce away from sitting up perfectly for Harrison. Campbell, that one is stolen at the front by the Warriors. And now they look to set them all.
She's fine. Kate
Mackenzie Carson making a nuisance of herself, and it's free ball. But it is a penalty against Worcester, so for Worcester, I should say. And it's taken quickly by Mattison, but too quickly for the referee. We'll come back for that penalty. Good composure shown by the Warriors again there, and despite Saracens being ahead on the scoreboard, Worcester haven't really put a foot wrong so far.
There's your mark.
Focusing in there on Hannah Black. As that line out goes slightly too quickly for the referee. Really good abrasive ball carrier in the centres for the visitors.
Again, one and three, binds up, can you see that higher?
And that line out, yeah. A let off for Saracens, not straight in the end. It'll be a scrum again. And Donna, we're straight back into one of your favourite things on a rugby field.
Love a scrum.
Olivia Vass then with her hands on the ball. Little view there of Juan Fagalo on the sideline. Chippy, as he's known at Saracens. Nice interplay from Aitchison to Harrison, and there's space here, and McKenna breaking free and feeding Lossie Clapp. Clapp puts her foot down, breaks through the first tackle. Lydia Thompson hauls her to ground, but Vera Vass is there quickly. The pass though to Marley Packer is disrupted well, and Packer having to fight to get to ground, and Poppy Cleal comes away with it now. Vera Vass thinks she's been played there without the ball, but play on. And May Campbell tidies that one up. Back in possession now, Vera Vass, and Harrison out the back to Aitchison. And there's Mackenzie Carson. Fantastic line there from the converted prop. Harrison just searching for opportunities, and she's found Sarah McKenna, and McKenna's got loads of space, and she's into the 22. And Via Vass back to Evans again. And Aitchison this time at first receiver to May Campbell. What a line from May Campbell.
What a line.
Kat McNanay, though, does brilliantly to pull her to ground at the last minute. But Saracens, 5 metres out, hunting for the ball. Time off, though.
Stand there. Got an injury. You guys have a penalty.
Campbell staying down after that carry. That one looks like it's her knee.
It gives me the ick.
Definitely gives you the ick. Fingers crossed for May Campbell. But that was some line from the hooker there, Donna.
That was a great line. I thought she was going to score that.
I think you've got to give credit as well to that last tackler as well, though, to see where Campbell was angling herself for the step. We look at it here.
No, it's a
brilliant, brilliant line off of Aitchison. Brilliant flat pass from Aitchison, and Campbell was away. You can see McNanay fighting to get over there, and in the end, it was Lydia Thompson, actually, that made the tackle.
Yeah, that was a great cover tackle, that.
May Campbell still down on the floor, and obviously the medical team quite rightly taking as much time as possible. The subs warming up below us. Jodie Retty may be called into action sooner rather than later.
I really hope she's just banged it on this hard ground. I really hope it's no more than that.
Well, fingers crossed. 13 minutes or so into this game then, Donna, you can see Juan Fagalo going through some instructions there on the pitch. How would you assess how this has gone as Campbell gets back to her feet and back into the action?
Yeah, we're looking back to our ways. We're looking hungry for the ball. Marley's over the balls again. But Worcester's doing a good shift in defence here.
No, on the line, please. Penn's going to be here. On the line. Okay. Time's back on. Jacqueline.
Let's see what happens then. We'll restart with a penalty for Saracens. May Campbell back to her feet. Looks happy and content to continue for the moment at least.
Okay, let's speed this up, Saris.
And that one, another wraparound. This time it's Marley Packer coming on at pace. She's stopped well on the game line, but then Louise McMillan. Oh, Louise, the call from Donna. And a fantastic try again from the second row, her third in Saracens colours. She joked after the DMP game that her mates were telling her she needed to reach out and actually dive properly for the line. Well, we saw that there. And that was just, again, a really good, hard line. And really, really clever play to see where the try line was and reach out.
Every time she scores, I say to her in the changing room, just before she scores, if you're going to score today, you're going to have a really good game. And today I didn't get to see her, but Louise, this is for you, and I knew you were going to do that.
Brilliant pick-up as well, actually, because Worcester had done really well to defend that first initial carry from Packer, but it's just the disguise on it. And we look at the replay here. McMillan just gets her hand, sees the gap, goes straight through, and Brinkett's not able to stop her, and she reaches out superbly.
Yeah, that's clever play, looking up, seeing that gap and taking it.
Zoe Harrison then, no mistake from the tee. It's 14-0 to Saracens, and they'll be really pleased with that. 14 minutes on the clock, 14 points, two tries, and two really clever tries from quick tap penalties.
Going left or right? Again, same picture, keep them behind you.
Back underway there, and that one isn't what Saracens would have wanted. Spilt forwards. And Worcester, that one's then lost forward by them. But a scrum for the Warriors, a good outcome for them. And it's that old adage, isn't it, of as soon as you scored a try, you need to keep your composure and clear your lines, and accuracy just lacking a little bit there for Saracens.
You rarely see that, Marley dropping that ball. I think the sun must have been in her eyes.
Yeah, I'll set back. Crouch!
Another scrum then. This time it's a Worcester put-in note. And Mattison.
This loose head here is taking Kelsey's chest. Kelsey's leaving it open, and that loose head is taking it all day long.
Carmen Trenoling there displaying the dark arts in the front row. But Worcester have the ball though, and Paige Farries does brilliantly actually there in the end to stay in play after a huge shot coming in from Saracens. It was Sarah McKenna with that shot. an advantage for Worcester as well, then back up on the Saracens 22. Kershaw gets that one out, the ball's fumbled forwards, but we'll come back for the penalty, and it's just the response that Worcester would have wanted.
9, that's enough of that appealing. Okay, don't buy it. 13, offside. Yeah.
Into touch then from the Warriors. Probably would have wanted a little bit more distance on that one. No, if they're being honest with themselves, but line out has been going well so far, and they did look like they were motoring a little bit last time they got the ball. Let's see what they do this time then. That first phase was really good, that first part was good. Lana Skeldon then with her hands on the ball at the back. Mattison hands on hips, content to let her pack go to work. Saracens though marshalling it really well, and Farries picks up, and Farries has found a brilliant line, and Farries straight through. Worcester on the board.
That was great. That was a great try.
Brilliant try, and what a stunning line from Paige Farries.
Great vision there. Saracens had great defence there. They're all low. It's a driving ball these days is more like a scrum. You've got to get low and really hold your feet.
Oh, let's look at it here. Mattison to Farries, and she picked it up straight behind, saw where the dog leg was. And by the time Marley Packer had realised what was happening, Farries was away and gone.
Okay. That's a
look at it here again. She's picked it up, sees that space, backs her pace. And a really, really clever finish from the Canadian international.
Yeah, I've got you.
Worcester then line up the conversion. That one just drifts to the right of the post, so it's 14-5.
As long as I've got
17 minutes on the clock.
Okay.
And you have to say,
hi Chris,
Donna, Saracens have done really well with the opportunities they've had, but Worcester's defence has been so solid. They've got themselves into those positions, and scoreline at the moment is probably a fair reflection of the game.
Yeah, I think Saracens, you know, we're coming out fighting, but we're making them silly errors by maybe giving them gaps to spot and run through. Letting them hold us in a driving maul. You've got to get your head out of there and get back in that line.
Thanks, 11. Kick her. Go, go.
Back underway then, Katie Mattison with her hands on the ball. And then gets that one away, but to Sarah McKenna only. And there is space for Saracens. Corinne Grant having a look, seeing where the space is. Corinne Grant's made that first break. It's brilliant for Corinne Grant. Eventually hauled to ground. And then a loose ball.
Thanks.
But it's still in Saracens' hands. And there's Carson. Harrison fizzes that one off to Marley Packer.
It was a great hit there.
It's a brilliant hit on her. You can see Worcester really targeting those big
really
ball carriers. And again, a flat ball out to May Campbell. Flo Long manages to drag her down, and big shot coming in on Sydney Gregson. I heard the wall from you there, Donna. And Viervas in the end forced to kick through. That one dribbles into touch in the 22. And again, Worcester, as we said, targeting those big ball carriers and making really, really clever and sensible decisions around the tackle area.
Yeah, that was a clever decision to put her down there, because, you know, if she tipped Sydney there, that would be a card, but she's cleverly just put her back down on her feet and put her on the floor carefully.
Carefully being the key word there.
What time are you on?
Time off then with a Worcester player down, just receiving a little bit of treatment. Just Corinne Graham there with that break. We saw that replay a few moments ago. Getting a real good run of games this season in a Saracen shirt, and really showing what she can do. Really pacey, really attacking. Was out at the World Cup with Scotland, sadly didn't get any minutes, but again, another, you wouldn't say undiscovered gem, she's been around the squad for a while, but a player that's really taken her opportunity.
Absolutely, she's really taken her opportunity in the last couple of games. She's really stood up. She's really impressed me. She's great.
I know, the one down where they scored the try, the rolling.
There's a number of players like that this season that have come through and shown what they can do. Corinne Grant, Sharifa Kasolo, who's on the bench today.
Yeah.
And then a couple of those younger players that have had to become experienced heads whilst the likes of yourself, Donna, and all the other internationals have been away on World Cup duty.
I think that's what's great about the World Cup is it's and us having a cut while the World Cup's happening. It's given them younger ones to really step up and put their hands up for the shirts for the Premiership.
Line out then successful from the Warriors. That one was pretty clinical, to put it mildly. And Mattison then again has her hands on the ball.
And that one
is whacked as far down the field as Hannah Bluck physically can. Only as far as Corinne Grant though, and Sarah McKenna looks to get the pass away, but it's disrupted and Worcester hack through. But it's been lost
in the tackle
forward by the Warriors. And stand a let-off again for Saracens because Paige Farries was herring after that one.
Knocked on in the tackle.
There's Sydney Gregson there in shot as we come back now onto the scrum. Marley Packard is having a few words with the referee as well. You can see what Saracens are trying to do, but that defence from Worcester on the outside is doing what it needs to do at the moment and just sort of blunting the attack a little bit.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
This is better by Kelsey. She was pinning her arm there, not letting her to take that chest.
And a clever little wraparound play in the end, and Aitchison goes searching for the space.
Flat!
And a brilliant offload, brilliant tip on. Saracens back on the attack. There's Cleal with the carry.
That is fine.
Viervas to Harrison to Carson. Nearly managed to get the hands away, and Viervas again. Harrison, McKenna, so many touches already in this match for the fullback. Packer takes it on herself.
No, it's fine. Ball is there. Don't push it back into her. Timing's fine.
Cleal never takes a backward step, Poppy Cleal. Sydney Gregson then tries to get around the outside, tries to escape. Not quite able to though. Saracen still probing, still building, and a little dink over the top from Zoe Harrison, taken brilliantly by Holly Aitchison. She gets the ball away to Kelsey Clifford, and Saracens back on the attack again. Referee just slightly in the way, but Saracens looking again for the opportunity. Fizzed wide superbly from Harrison, releasing Corinne Grant with a silky offload and a brilliant score from the winger. Donna, that was fantastic.
That was a great team try. The ball was going through the hands for Corinne there to finish it off.
We were just talking about Corinne Grant a few moments ago, but what a couple of phases from Zoe Harrison, showing her international quality. First with that brilliant little dink over the top, brilliantly taken by Holly Aitchison, gets it away to Kelsey Clifford. And then as the play just carried on, the wherewithal to fizz that ball right across the face to Cleal, and then really, really soft hands from Cleal to release the winger.
Do you know what I love there is our tight heads just there for that little offload.
Is that where you want to be when you're back on the field, getting those hands free?
I'll be scoring, I'll be under this try line.
Zoe Harrison then adds the extras, another really good conversion. 21-5 Saracens lead, and well, Donna, you said pre-match that, that Kelsey was just keeping the shirt warm for you, but she's doing more than that so far this afternoon.
God, I got a fight on my hands, haven't I?
But that strength in depth is what we talk about all the time, having so many capable players in positions so that if the likes of yourself are sadly not able to be out on the field, brilliant players like Mackenzie, like Kelsey, like Mika and Alex on the bench today can just come in and pick up the shirt.
Yeah, it is. As a prop and having them amazing props, you'll be fighting for a shirt, and when I come back I don't think it's going to be easy at all.
Saris then with their hands back on the ball.
Wait, stop. Okay, you're all good.
And that one goes long, taken by Mattison. And Worcester, brilliant tip on there.
Great offload.
Unbelievable offload. Farries thought about getting the pass away to Wright Haley. Wright Haley slightly in front of us, sensibly holding onto it, and then Flo Long. Great carry from Flo Long. You don't see many people go over the top of May Campbell like that. And Kershaw and Bluck again. And Worcester building nicely here. Worcester have found the space. Tackle needed to be made, and Marley Packer was there at the crucial moment. Green Grant, that one's a little bit wobbly, and it's gone into touch. And despite a brilliant read from Marley Packer, not the worst outcome for Worcester by any stretch of the imagination.
Yeah, it's yours.
You know, Worcester have big runners as well, and I think what they did there was draw people in and then offload their backs there. That was great. That was a great bit of play from them.
And the pressure, importantly for the Warriors, staying on as well.
Maul.
And they get that maul working again, driving forward. They've not really used it to its full potential so far this afternoon. They've used it as they're doing now to feed those big ball carriers. Nice block, big carry from the centre.
Turnover's good.
But Marley Packer again comes away with it and then channels her inner Zoe Harrison with some boot to clear it. May Campbell then looks to be the first one up there, unable to make the tackle, but then the Saracen support gets there, helps her out, and Worcester now hemmed back in their half.
Penalty
advantage for the Warriors as well there for an indiscretion at the breakdown. But I tell you what, as Mattison just throws caution to the wind there, that was some nudge from Marley Packer, and Zoe Harrison might be asking him for a few tips.
That was a really good nudge by Mar. Really, really good nudge.
Number 7, side entry.
Despite that brilliant nudge though, it is a penalty for the Warriors. And they'll hem this one back down into Saracen's half. Unless Lottie Clapp can keep it in play, and she does that brilliantly. A little pass out of the back. And then nearly a fantastic clearance kick back into touch. Mattison though responds. And Veervaat has to go tracking back. And in the end, worked out brilliantly for Mattison. And looks like the 50-22 was on.
50-22, what's the line out?
Great kick there.
50-22 was on. We can hear, yes, Katie Mack from the Worcester coaches behind us. And despite Lottie Clapp's heroics, in the end, Worcester Warriors exactly back where they want to be.
Let's speed this up, Worcester.
Line out again, good from the Warriors.
Hold. Back.
That's great defence by Saracens.
Okay, now you're in.
Really good defence. And Worcester having to hunt for the ball. Skeldon comes away with it. Pulled to ground by Kelsey Clifford and Mattison. Cleal there with a clever little hand just to disrupt the scrum half, but Worcester still have the ball. Now Mattison is back in position. There's Brinkert with the ball. She's tackled hard this time. And there's Karis Cox, and the ball going wide, and Bluck with a little chip over the top. Ooh. And it's caught Sarah McKenna out, and Paige Farries, is she going to get it? She has.
Wow.
Fantastic again from Paige Farries, a brilliant read. And it's the bounce of a rugby ball, it does strange things, Donna.
That's the thing about Paige, she's got that magic, hasn't she?
It's a good try.
She really does have that magic, Paige Farries. You could see her there almost just begging the ball to sit up for her. It was a really clever little kick through from Bluck. A really difficult one for McKenna to have to deal with. And by the time Farries was there, a little foot on it, and then a really, really good finish. And then actually, you know what? Fair play to the cameraman. A nice little bit of nimble footwork there to jump out of her way as well. Great play all round from everybody there. And Farries looks understandably delighted with that one. And Worcester again, right back in the match.
This is what I said in my before the match interview. You know, you can't rule Worcester out. They're always fighting back. They're a great squad.
And it's that belief that runs through this side as well. Joe Yap has been there a few years now. It's a side that really has her stamp on it.
Hiya.
And 21-10 with the conversion, not quite having the legs. We talk about putting an imprint on the side. Just mentioned Joe Yap there, and there she is on the screen. This Worcester side sort of typifies her, really, doesn't it? Never giving up, never giving in, and fighting for absolutely every single inch. That one then, a knock-on from Worcester, and Saracens straight back in the attacking area that they want to be in. Nearly half an hour on the clock. A really entertaining first half as well. And Viervas then with her hands on the ball. Been some really, really good play so far. And I think the one thing we've seen from Saracens, two tries from the forwards, one from the back. I saw a stat this week that did make me sort of stand up in shock, that Saracens have only scored six tries this season before today through the back so far. Kareem Grant then with the seventh, but it really shows just how important the work of that tight group of eight is for everything that happens here in black and red. Viervas then gets that one away to Zoe Harrison, and Harrison inside ball to Aitchison, and a brilliant break from Lottie Platt. Brilliant tap tackle. Then a strip on the ball, and Block clears it. And Aitchison has to go herring back after this one alongside Harrison, McKenna. Zoe Harrison just head over heels there, has a little look around, gets used to where she is again. Wasn't quite sure with the ground suddenly above her for a split second, but they're back in the swing of things now, and Viervas just controlling things from the base. Marley Packer, that one looks slightly forward from Sydney Gregson, but play on. And now Gregson again puts her foot down and goes. Sydney Gregson's away here for Saracens. Goes through the first tackle, looks for Kareem Grant, can't find her, she's going for herself. Sydney Gregson, support running away from it, but she's back in possession, and Saracens back into the 22. And Viervas to Campbell.
Oh, what a bosh.
What a bosh indeed. More huge defensive action from the Warriors. A little dink through. That's again. Tricky. Who's going to win the race? In the end, it's the ball. It bounces dead. Sydney Gregson there. That was some line and some break. She just needed that support to stay with her.
Well, I think the support, she was running away. I think she was playing it with Kareem Grant there. But it was a fantastic line and a fantastic effort.
22.
And the result of it, after all of that, will end up being a goal line dropout for the Warriors. But for Saracens, the fact that they are being able to exploit these spaces will be a really, really positive sign for Alex Alsterbury heading into half-time in 10 minutes or so's time. A little bit of time off here with a Warriors player receiving some treatment.
Yeah, it's time off, yeah.
And a little bit of work going into the leg there. Donna, 32 minutes on the clock, three tries to two. Really entertaining game, actually, and crowd being treated to some fantastic running rugby.
Okay, yeah.
It's been back and forth.
Water off.
Like I said before, never rule Worcester out. They've got that fight, they've got that dog in it, and I love it.
Well, running repairs sorted. And it will be a Worcester 22 dropout to get us underway. Kareem Grant, unfortunate in the end there, looks down, saw the white line below her foot. You could see that little throw out of the hands in frustration. But a really good nudge, actually, from the Warriors as well, just to put that pressure on and make Grant have to really think about where she was. And there she is, coming back into shot, Kareem Grant. Line out then for the Warriors, taken well again in the middle, and Mattison away to Bluck quickly, and Bluck out the back and nearly through, but it's gone forward, and Poppy Cleal comes away with it, gets it out of the back of the hands. And George Evans and Louise McMillan and Mackenzie Carson goes past Float Long, goes nearly through Paige Farries. Farries does brilliantly to stop her, and Georgia Evans then.
Who needs backs, eh?
Who needs backs? Louise McMillan, though, is away. Louise McMillan, brilliant turn of pace. And Saracens are in for their fourth. It's Louise McMillan's second. And that, Donna Rose, was an absolute streamer. As she said, who needs backs?
That was great. That was good. These tries are a great team effort today. It's not just one person standing up. The whole team is standing up.
And look at that. Okay. Louise McMillan can see the legs going, the arms reaching out. And that turn of pace, you have to say, so, so impressive.
She's actually quite quick, isn't she?
I think she surprised you a little bit there with that turn of pace.
Didn't know if it's her or Sydney.
Louise McMillan certainly making a name for herself in these parts.
Oh, I think she's been a great signing for us this season. I think she does all the dog work. She's great.
Zoe Harrison keeping up her 100% record from the tee. 4 from 4 and 28-10 at the score for Saracens. 4 tries to 2. Bonus point in the bag.
Worcester, just hold it there. Got to sort out Cox. Tell them to hold it.
And Worcester Warriors have been really impressive, but Saracens have been really clinical. 4 opportunities in the 22 and 4 tries. And that's the sort of direct play that Alex Horsby will be really pleased to have seen so far.
Scrum advantage.
Ball bobbling around, lost forward again though, and for the second time this afternoon, we talk about those errors or lack of errors after a try has been scored, and it's handling again there, not quite as Saracens would have wanted it. A scrum again for Worcester, back in the Saracens 22 again.
That's by Kelsey here. Oh, she's lifted her arm up. Oh!
Penalty though for Saracens. And Ella Veervas has seen some space and has gone quickly here. And Aitchison and Gregson. And Gregson gets on the outside arc to Corinne Grant. Bobbles it, holds onto it well.
Hand away! Scrum advantage!
Saracens though have lost the ball forward and Worcester come away with it.
Go back for the knock-on.
In the end, a knock-on. Abby Kershaw has the ball in her hands and it will be a scrum for Worcester. But that was a real statement from Saracens at that last scrum, Donna. We've not seen much of it so far this half, but the pack, we've seen what they can do in the loose, but the nitty-gritty there in the front row as well.
I was a bit worried there that Kelsey let her have her test in the end, but she's such a strong little ball, bless her.
Strong little ball, that's some way of describing Kelsey Clifford. Powerhouse in the front row and still just 21 years old as well.
Bind.
Despite all of that though,
Set. It
is a scrum for the Warriors.
Stay up, stay up. Backwards.
And the ball went backwards in the end, but Paige Farries has to tidy up for her side. Marley Packer making a nuisance of herself there, and Saracens all over that at the breakdown and coming away with it.
Leave it, hands away.
It's a real arm wrestle on the ball there. It's come back on the Worcester side, and there is an opportunity here, and it's Wright Haley that sets off, ducks through the first tackle, keeps going. So powerful, so industrious.
May Campbell there trying to get that rip.
And she's done it really successfully as well for her side, and they've come away with the ball.
No hands away.
Sydney is very feisty. It's great to have her in the backs.
Hold.
Just talk a little bit about Sydney Gregson then, as Zoe Harrison absolutely leathers that one down the field. And then a knock-on from Worcester as well. She's done so well to come back from that injury that ruled her out for pretty much the whole of last season. Little setback again after making her comeback against Bristol in the cup, but like you said, so feisty and such an important player for this group.
She's definitely important to this group. She's, you know, as soon as she's found out I had a knee injury, she messaged me and got behind me straight away, there for advice and everything. Injury did set her back, but I think mentally she's very strong and she came back better.
I suppose that's the thing you want from any player, isn't it? Injury setbacks a lot, but you come back better, you come back stronger. And I know from your perspective and from the Saracens perspective as well, that's what everybody will be hoping when you're able to pull on that black and red shirt again.
Stay up, stay strong.
Veervas then puts that one in. And it's bouncing about, and Farries is away. She thinks she's in for a hat trick.
Oh. I like watching Paige. She's got a bit of magic about her. She's like the showman.
She really is a showman, but that had just come off a Worcester hand. Farries there looks so disappointed. She thought she was away again. But that is half-time. A little bit early, it looked like. on our clock, I think.
Okay. So,
a little bit of a confusing end to that half, but that is half time. Both sides then heading into the changing rooms. A slightly confused end to that one in the end, Donna, but 28-10 at half time. A really entertaining game, and well, we can get back into the swing of things now. How would you assess how that one's gone?
I think, you know, we've come out fighting and hungry. Just some silly errors, really, letting balls bounce. And then the greatest showman picks it up, really. Yeah, but I think it's been a fantastic game to watch, and I'm excited for the second half.
Well, talked about the entertainment factor there. Let's look through some of those highlights from that first half. And we'll start with this. Kelsey Clifford's try on her 50th appearance. Brilliant play round the back, and Poppy Cleal popping it off for the prop to power through. And then this second try, Saracens tried it again with Marley Packer coming round the corner, but Louise McMillan doing all she can to pick it up, reach out those long, long levers and get the ball down for her side. A brilliant score from McMillan there, her first of the match. And then Worcester hit back with this, and it has to be said, sumptuous score from Paige Farries. Saw the space, went straight through, and there was no stopping. The Canadian winger then, that was her first of the match. Saracens, though, this was arguably the highlight of the half so far. Holly Aitchison taking on that chip from Zoe Harrison, getting away to Clifford, and then the handling from Harrison and Cleal to get that wide for Corinne Grant really was something, Donna.
Such a team try. I love that, getting it through the hands.
And Corinne Grant then hairing over for the score. Just get a really good angle of that pass here. That was absolutely on the money.
That's textbook there by Poppy. You know, you get the player coming to you and you offload it just as they're there. Means they're aiming for you and they're leaving your winger.
And here we go then. Speaking of wingers, Paige Farries. Brilliant awareness there to see that bobbling ball. And then beat Sarah McKenna, who had to readjust and get the ball in. It was really, really good play. And then this try here. Georgia Evans with the carry. Louise McMillan with the supporting line, and she was away for her second of the afternoon. Sprinter's pedigree almost there from McMillan.
Phew. Should give Usain Bolt a run for his money.
It was fantastic play from McMillan there, as we said. As we said at the start of the show, though, none of these live streams would be possible without the fantastic partners we have here at Saracens. And we just want to take a couple of minutes again here to say thank you to them.
An unprecedented market force is causing a shift in direction. There may be some long-term opportunity if traders can see through the noise.
Master the market forces with City Index. Trade with confidence.
Just do your best. What you
Well, an incredibly entertaining first 40 minutes here at StoneX Stadium. Saracens women 28 points to 10 up against University of Worcester Warriors. And we've got something entertaining in store for you now. Alex Austerbury, Sonia Green, where do you stand? Sliders, are they a yes? Are they a no? Karaoke on the bus, and more importantly, from Sonic's perspective, what are her views on Alex Austerbury's, as he would describe it, positive shouts from the coach's box?
Where do you stand on socks and sliders being acceptable?
Criminal offence.
Okay, this must be an age thing, because it's outrageous. Like, I don't care how easy it makes walking around the change room, it just shouldn't be allowed.
Like, it's wrong on multiple levels.
Yeah.
One, aesthetically disgusting.
Yeah.
Two, what structural support does it give the ankle joint? We need to look
our
after those.
Our physios would be upset about this.
Oh, just ban them. And onesies, ban them as well.
Alex, where do you stand? Push over try? Go down as a team try or not?
Oh, absolutely. Fundamentally, everyone's got to play their part in getting there. And then obviously
outrageous.
The forwards finish
outrageous.
It off.
Outrageous.
Everyone works in unison. That's what a good team is. So in fact, let's go broaden it out. Every try is a team try. Everyone helps get it there.
Spot the backs coach.
If it wasn't for the kicking game, it weren't for the backs throwing the ball around.
Push over try is definitely a forwards try.
Okay, right.
May Campbell would definitely say it's May Campbell's try, as someone who doesn't score many tries.
So
it's
your logic's flawed then. So it's a team try when it's just the forwards involved.
May's
but
in May's in my team.
Oh, it's a clique, is it?
Yeah, it's absolutely full on clique.
I'm about the team ethos. So
forwards.
Yeah, stats say it's May's try, so I'm going to go with that. Sonic, where do you stand on forwards kicking in open play?
Definitely should be allowed to kick in open play. No, I'm too scared with the result that I'll get from you. I want to play the next week, so yeah, no, forwards shouldn't kick in. But unless, it depends on the score, and unless you're Marley Packer, she gets away with it.
I think if you've got the skill set to execute against it, you work hard on it in training, then every player's a rugby player. But ultimately, if you've not got it in your locker, just keep it tucked away for a rainy day. Yeah.
Like I did a few seasons ago, yeah?
In all honesty, it will depend on the end product. If it comes out and it's pretty decent, like a Poppy Khalil spiral kick that goes 50 metres, you're like, oh, that's all right. If it's a Kelsey Clifford chip and chase, she's got a little bit of history with that. So again, you're comfortable with it. If it's someone who you might not have seen do a lot of kicking, or you've seen them do a lot of kicking and you think they should probably be throwing a ball rather than kicking it, then it's like, oh God, what's going to happen next? This could lead to some chaotic situation. But hopefully, we're upskilling everyone to make better decisions and execute against those decisions. So
that's a very diplomatic answer, Alex. What would happen is he'd just scream. You would just scream.
Can't hear me in a new glass box.
Right.
So it'd be a quiet word in a player's ear.
Yeah.
Saying something along the lines, please don't do that again. It's quite stressful.
Yeah, if it pays off, if it's like Marley kicking or a chip and chase from Kelsey, then it's okay. But I want to train or play the next week. I don't do it. So forwards just stick to what we do well.
Which is scoring team tries.
Alex, where do you stand on coaches shouting from the box having a positive impact on players' performance?
Absolutely. It's just showing their encouragement, that energy and enthusiasm, just sharing that with the players. They know that you're in the fight with you. You might not be on the pitch, but you're there in spirit. Mm. So I think it has a massively positive impact on non-officials as well. They really enjoy it.
Let's just say I'm really glad that the new box has glass around it this season.
The door opens, it's fine. I'll be able to share my enthusiasm with you.
I just try and shut Alex off.
It's just me who makes noise.
You're the loudest, definitely.
I think we've got some more vocal people
closer to pitch. Chippy's quite loud as well, but
he's
guess
closer.
But Chippy's giving useful information. Maybe that's just because I'm a forward. But
he's getting it fed into his ear.
Screaming and shouting is... Especially because I played quite a few games on the bench last season, so I just had to get really good at blocking you out.
Ultimately, it's important information that's shared with you guys, and it's obviously had a real good impact because we've done all right.
Well, it obviously worked. Yeah. Obviously worked.
You'd miss it if there was no voice there. You'd be like, oh, what's up with him today? Sonic, where do you stand with karaoke? That really important subject. It's not about how it's sung, it's more about the song that you choose.
100%. It's about the song choice.
Yeah, I've got to say the song choice. And if you've got anything about you, you choose a song where everyone's going to join in as well.
And then
pressure's off.
You basically don't have to sing, someone else does it for you.
Yeah, 100%. And these, the youngsters on the bus, though, they're awful, aren't they? Choose this song, no one's ever heard of.
We don't know the words.
Yeah.
Actually, you're pretty good on karaoke, especially on song choice as well.
Well, exactly, being around the block, aren't we? Yeah. We know what to choose.
Yeah, on the coach back from the Premiership final, actually, there were some good song choices there.
So it's important that you engage everyone in karaoke, otherwise you've got to be really, really good, or you get mocked for life.
Alex singing Avril Lavigne.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, which song was that? Avril Lavigne.
Complicated.
Complicated. Yeah, you know all the words. That was amazing.
But also, it's kind
highlight of
my mission
win,
of my coaching as well. You know, complicate, because players complicate things. Simple game. Coaches make it easy. So, hence the song choice.
It was one of my highlights of the win the Premier.
I'm trying to think. Who has got a voice? Has anyone got a voice?
Kelsey's not bad.
Oh yeah, Teenage Dirt. She didn't know Teenage Dirtbag though, did she?
There you go. There you go.
Let herself down there. When it comes to singing, there's not a great deal of talent.
No.
No, there's.
We'll stick to rugby. Okay, Alex, I've got a really good one for you.
All right, okay.
Where do you stand on socks and sliders being acceptable?
Criminal offence.
Okay, this must be an age thing, because it's outrageous. Like, I don't care how easy it makes walking around the change room, it just shouldn't be allowed.
It's wrong on multiple levels.
Yeah.
One, aesthetically disgusting.
Yeah.
Two, what structural support does it give the ankle joint? We need to look
Our
after those things.
Our physios would be upset about this.
Oh, I just... Honestly, and it's the in thing.
Yeah,
Crocs and socks.
Crocs and socks.
Sliders.
Burks and socks. Sliders.
I just don't comprehend it.
Just barefoot, flip flops, or socks.
I tell you who wins. Marketeers. They're the ones who've made that happen. Up there with Valentine's Day. That is a right con.
Outrageous.
Oh, honestly, ban them. And onesies, ban them as well. Cara, she's a slider and a sock girl, but she's got these glitterati sliders as well.
Actually, yeah, G has fluffy ones.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, she's got fluffy.
They're
ones.
More like grand slippers, missing a bit, aren't they?
Yeah, flip flops with his socks.
Yeah,
the
socks just adds it to a whole new level of wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
Can we move on? This is uncomfortable.
Well, incredibly entertaining there from Sonic, Sonia Green and Alex Austerbury. Donna, I'll ask you on that one, because that was the big question there between the pair of them. Where do you stand on socks and sliders?
Absolutely. I wear them all the time.
Alex Austerbury was not particularly keen on them, it had to be said, but he will be pretty keen and pretty happy with what he's seen from his side in that first 40 minutes.
It was quiet in the changing rooms, as in he's not shouting and I can't hear him, so it must be going well.
How does that work in the changing rooms then, that dynamic, what people don't see on the screens in terms of those messages at half time?
I think Alex comes in and he's very honest with us. He doesn't beat around the bush, he's just very honest. He's got that winning ways, hasn't he? So he's comes in, tells us what we need to do, and we hopefully go out and finish the job for him.
Well, they've certainly been doing the job so far. One other thing for us to mention at this point, we've talked about the duel a lot today, but one thing we haven't mentioned is a fantastic opportunity for all of you listening in and watching on at home. If you purchase a ticket for the duel today on saracens.com, and by today I mean by 23:59:59, basically do it before midnight, then you will automatically be entered into a competition to win an opportunity to meet the players at the training ground and here at the stadium. It's a fantastic opportunity for all of those who purchased their tickets today, and a wonderful chance to come and meet the likes of Donna, Marley, Zoe and everybody else that's part of this Saracen squad. And Donna, whilst we're just waiting for the players to come back out, those links with the fans that are being built here at Saracens, as much as what happens on the field is fantastic, it's all about that synergy with the fans and what they bring to as well to the team.
Absolutely. I think the fans give us that extra 10%, and you know, the fans live by the Saracens way as well. They go to the men's, they go to the women's, you know, there's they love the men's, they love the women's. We're just the family. The fans, great. They give us that extra 10. Absolutely.
And Saracens Mavericks Netball as well, part of that Saracens family. They kick off, I say kick off, shouldn't say that with netball. Probably. Their first centre pass of the season is on the 11th of February at the season opener for the Netball Super League at the Motorpoint Arena in Nottingham. Their first
proper home match of the season is a week later against Leeds Rhinos at Hertfordshire Sports Village. Seasonal memberships of the Mavericks are still available on saracens.com, as well as individual match tickets. And Donna, we're talking about the family there, as you said, but with Mavericks as well, they come down, they watch the games. I've seen a couple of the Saracens women's players, the likes of Chloe Langdale, that have been going to their pre-season fixtures as well, and really keeping together as a solid group here at Saracens.
Yeah, I forgot to mention them. Sorry, netball. I'll be with you soon anyway, because I can't do contact, so I need to throw a ball around somewhere. It's great, you know, all three teams, and you know, we've got the school, we've got the academy, we've got everything at this club. It's quite a decent club, isn't it? So, like I said, we're one big happy family, unless we lose.
It really is one big family, and here is a family of 15 making their way back out onto the field. Saracens women returning for the start of the second half, and Worcester Warriors as well. And that familiar run-on music being blared out around the PA systems here. There's Marley Packer having a laugh, having a joke with Holly Aitchison. They'll both be happy with their work so far this afternoon. It'll be Worcester Warriors who get us back underway. No changes for either side at half time.
Okay, you go. Yeah, I've got you. Go. Yeah, if you're going left or right.
Okay. And we just wait for referee Holly Wood to blow her whistle. And there it is. Abby Kershaw gets us back underway. Marley Packer, all smiles before the restart. But straight back into the nitty-gritty of it there. May Campbell with a tip on to Mackenzie Carson.
No, rock your feet! Okay, hold, wait for.
And that one has gone high, and it's bouncing all over the place. And Lottie Clapp is there, but a brilliant offload away to Mattison, and she ducks and weaves away from Marley Packer, eventually pulled to ground. And Worcester without their scrum half at the moment. Strong tackle coming in, but Worcester doing well to align and reset for Mattison to get back into position. Kershaw there has been absolutely melted by Kelsey Clifford. Great shot. And the fly half did really well to get the ball away. Thanks. Polly Aitchison, though, has the ball. Returns that one in kind. And that one bounces and bobbles into touch. Worcester, though, play it quickly, straight over the heads of Clapp and McKenna, looking to inject some pace into this one. And they set off in the middle of the field. It's Karis Cox there that's made really, really good yards for her side.
Thanks, Gray.
And Worcester just content to press, build, probe. Farries the danger woman there with a little inside ball to Cox again. And Worcester going down that narrow short side right. Haley gets her hands on the ball, goes through that tackle from Viervas. Mattison and the tip on, but the tip on's gone forward straight into the hands of Kelsey Clifford.
Is it?
Saracens just slightly slow to react, and Marley Packer then off to Evans. Skeldon looks for the rip, can't quite get it, and Harrison chips that one in behind. And there is a real race on here, and it's a bouncing ball, and Aitchison was after it, so was Clapp. And I tell you what, Worcester there, that was Hannah Bluck again, has done brilliantly to get out of that sticky situation for her side. The penalty for Saracens, holding on. Brilliant work by Georgia Evans. Evans probably be a little bit disappointed that the referee's whistle went there. She thought she was away.
She is a turnover queen, RG. Just behind Marley, I think.
Just beyond Marley. A change for Worcester Warriors there as well. Sarah Nicholas coming on for Hannah Bluck.
Okay.
And that kick from Zoe Harrison, pretty much as close to perfection. Okay. 5 metres out from the line.
Time's back on. Okay, you're on the line. Inside foot. Okay.
May Campbell then, waiting for her forwards pack to go minute discussions.
Set back, go on the line.
Not supposed to be seeing as much of that this side of the new year. Laws being amended now to make sure that they don't take ages over the set piece. A brilliant little move there from Saracens, though. Cleal coming round the corner looking to release Campbell.
Is she having another one?
Is Kelsey Clifford there for another one? Not quite. Saracens inches out from the line, but they are there that time.
Who's that? May. Shock.
Shock, says Donna Rose. Who else but May Campbell? Kelsey Clifford got a try early on in the first half for her 50th. May Campbell saw that and went, I fancy some of that myself at the start of the second half, Donna.
Showing off now, isn't it?
Just inside five.
It was definitely May Campbell there, picking, going. Georgia Evans with the support for her.
May's so cool, calm and collective. Look at her. Doesn't faze her anymore.
She really is. Just seems to pop up all the time at those crucial moments to go over for those scores. And already, as Zoe Harrison's first miss of the afternoon drifts just to the right of the uprights, already 8 tries in the league this season, 14 in league and cup. I don't quite know what the club record is for the most tries in a competitive season, but May Campbell must be fancying herself to get close to it, the rate she's going at the moment. Worcester then will get us back underway. Miscommunication by Packer and McIntosh, and Worcester with the knock-on advantage back up on the Saracens 22 pretty much instantly, and there's Skeldon. And there's Sarah Nicholas New onto the field. Stopping, going, checking. Mattison under all sorts of pressure there. And May Campbell looking to hold her up in contact. Sydney Gregson in there as well, Mackenzie Carson. And it's come back on the Saracen side. Marley Packer is away. And Aitchison now puts boot to ball. And that one is for Lottie Clapp to chase. There is space in behind. And Farries has let it bounce. And Clapp is tearing after this one. Puts the pressure in. Forces the knock on as well from Farries. Probably the first mistake she's made this afternoon, Donna. But a brilliant outcome for Saracens. A great chase from Lottie Clapp. And
on the floor.
Yeah, like we said, Paige Farries hasn't done a lot wrong this afternoon.
Yeah, I think Lottie's chase there was really put pressure on her, and I think that's why she's making mistakes. She's double taking
okay,
there and giving herself a knock on.
And the announcer here at the stadium correcting themselves, May Campbell with the try, and those Scottish pipes coming out over the tannoy. How many times have we heard those this season? At least the likes of Corrine, Jodie and Louise will feel right at home with those being played as well. It's a Saracen scrum though, and Veervas. Mattison hunts her down well, but she gets it away to Harrison. And there's Aitchison to McKenna. McKenna's tackled well, but Aitchison back for the offload and jumps away from McKenna and then goes head down into contact. A penalty though for Worcester, holding on. You can see the celebrations there. It's number 7 Charlotte Wright Haley with the turnover. Sarah McKenna and Charlotte Wright Haley just having a couple of little choice words of each other
ding,
there
ding.
And I say you can hear the ding ding there. Don't know, the PA announcer enjoyed that one.
Get the line. End of the white line. End of the white line, guys.
We mentioned it before the game, but a little bit of a reshuffle in that back row for the Warriors this afternoon. Alex Callender had been due to start, unfortunately had to withdraw late last night.
Whatever the reason being, I wish her well and I hope she's okay.
A mate of yours as well, and a phenomenal player when she's on the field.
Feisty she is, feisty.
Feisty is the word, and feisty is the word for a lot of what we've seen out on the field so far today as Lydia Thompson clap pulls her to ground. But Worcester are back up to that Saracens 22 now.
Great tackle there by G.
Georgia Evans then doing what she needs to do, but Worcester are still pressing, still probing, and Lydia Thompson.
I'm loving this battle between Lydia and Lottie.
Been a really, really good matchup, actually, hasn't it? Two incredibly experienced players, and both of them really going at it.
way to go. Thanks.
That was a great tackle by Ella there.
Really good tackle from Ella Veervas. And Worcester a little bit at sixes and sevens. And it's been ripped, and Aitchison did well. Gregson came away with it, and Donna, I can hear you laughing.
Okay, Holter, wait.
I don't know who was tackling who there.
Both of them weren't quite sure, but anyway, the outcome was a clearance kick from Saracens, and Worcester have their hands on the ball, but they've lost significant meters. And Mattison tries a little dink over the top. We saw what that did last time, and it's well, a little bit of confusion, a little bit of a play on, and in the end, a knock on and a scrum. Worcester's coach is up next to us there, Don. I think that one should have been a penalty for an accidental offside.
I know. But
Zoe Harrison just down with her arm in the air, asking for a little bit of treatment. How did you see that one there? It's going to be a scrum for Worcester, but how did you see it?
I feel like Worcester are panicking a little bit when they're in their half. They're kind of like kicking away the ball I don't know, they're just panicking a little bit.
Let's just have a little look at this replay here as Zoe Harrison receives some treatment. It's such an uncharacteristic one from her.
She has had a couple of knocks at training, hence why she wasn't playing last week, but I think she'll be okay. She's a fighter.
Fighter, she definitely is. Couple of players then receiving treatment at the moment across the field for both sides. There's been an awful lot of ball in play so far, it has to be said, and perhaps some of the pack and Mackenzie Carson there just starting to feel it a little bit.
Yeah, the forwards, you know, you'll see them changes starting to come on. It's nearly 50 on. You'll see definitely the front row, I think. They've been, especially Kelsey Clifford, wow, she's had a game and a half.
Thank you. Okay, water off. Okay.
Point back on. Alex Austerbury then pacing around in the coach's box. I wonder what he'll be making of what he's seen so far. All the players, though, running repairs complete and good to return to play. It will be
a
scrum, though, for the Warriors.
And this is a great angle. We can see Mac here and how she's going.
That's a perfect position for you to cast your eye over the front rows.
Her positioning there was okay, to be fair.
Okay.
I think she was sitting flow back on her back foot, really.
Just speak to us a little bit more about Mackenzie Carson then, and that sort of transition into the front row. How hard is it to get used to those dark arts and those structures?
Well, when I came to Saracens, I had a year in the dev, and it took me... I'm still learning now. I think every day when you transition into a front row, you know, you're learning every day. Definitely. Mackenzie is a great physical rugby player. She's from hooker to back row, but now she's given a shot at loose head, which isn't that bad. And third game in, I think she's holding her own.
All a little bit messy, all a little bit harem scarem in there, and a knock on.
Got two knock on
from Saracens, a knock on from Worcester, and we'll come back pretty much as you were. It'll be a scrum for the Warriors, a knock on from Saracens first, and going to be brutally honest, it was a little bit of a messy scrum and a little bit of a messy phase after that. So at least both packs have got a bit of a chance now to correct that.
I think Ella's going off there for Leanne. Which, that isn't a bad replacement, is it?
It really isn't, is it? We talked about that strength and depth in the first half, but Ella Veervas, again, still such a young player, but being replaced by Leanne Infante, England international, started her first game back for the club last week against Exeter, and as you said, not a bad sub to bring on by any stretch of the imagination.
Crouch!
Ella Veervas then on screen, putting on a sub's jacket. Don't blame her for doing that at all. It is a bitterly cold one today, despite the clear skies and the sun. Worcester scrum, though.
Use it!
That's great from Mackenzie. They're holding that scrum up.
Really good work from Mackenzie, but really good play from Worcester as well. And Lydia Thompson has won that little individual battle there with Lossie Clapp and Sarah McKenna. And in fact, she sent Clapp all the way back onto her bum.
And Worcester then into the Saracens 22 temporarily, and there's Kershaw feeding Joe Brown. And there's Karis Cox, and there is space here for Worcester, and they've flung it wide. Let's see what they can do. It's Lana Skeldon, an advantage coming out from the referee. Worcester realigning, keeping themselves going after that knock on there from a Saracen's hand.
I'd like to see that again to see if she did that.
Still
pen
advantage.
I say it did look deliberate, I've got to be honest, and we'll see. I think the referee is playing a penalty advantage. Amelia Buckland Hurry also has made her way off the field for Elizabeth Shermer, and we will come back for that penalty. Referee having a discussion as well.
Penalty only. Okay, cool. Okay, just here, Chris. Okay. Deliberate knock on in the tackle number 10.
So a deliberate knock on from Zoe Harrison, the decision, and that was clear as day. Just a penalty though, nothing more. But Worcester pumped that one into the corner, and an opportunity to try and push back and get their third try on the board.
Well done, Kelsey Clifford. You've done yourself proud, mate.
Two more changes then for Saracens as well. Alex Ellis coming on for 50 cap Kelsey Clifford, and Jess Breach coming on for Kareen Grant as well. Well done, Kelsey Clifford. You said there, Donna, some shift from her again this afternoon. Worcester wasting no time though as those two players make their way off the field, and they're 5 metres out. Penalty advantage coming. Georgia Evans collapsing that one.
Tackle, release, short.
And Worcester are right up to the line.
No.
The ball is in there somewhere. No advantage coming though, and we'll come back for that penalty. Really good defence on the line from Saracens, but Worcester knew they had that free shot. Back in to the corner then go the Warriors. And they set them all again.
That's great defence. They're going to spin that round, are they? Yeah.
Another penalty advantage, this time against Poppy Cleal. They're mounting up here. And Worcester still with that penalty advantage, as you can hear there from Hollywood, moving closer and closer to the line.
Number 8.
And it's going to be a yellow card for Poppy Cleal. Collapsing the mall the second time in quick succession, and for Poppy Cleal, a second yellow card in as many games. Worcester go back to the corner. It's really good defence from Saracens, Donna, right up on the line, but it's just errors in and around the line out at the moment that are allowing Worcester to keep them hemmed into this area.
I just think it's discipline, really. Great defence. We get low, we hold them in, you know, and you've... Here we go again.
Here we go again. Let's see what happens. Worcester are motoring here.
Yeah, there's all that.
And they're down. It's Lana Skeldon with the try. And in the end, there felt like a sense of inevitability about that one, a deserved third score for the Warriors.
Yeah, definitely. But, you know, Saracens are putting all their heads in there and not guarding the edges. If you do that, you're always going to have a hooker scoring.
And just look at this here, a perfectly set driving maul. Skeldon released and able to flop over the line without anybody touching her, really, in the end. Pretty much inch perfect from the Warriors, and following in Karis Phillips's footsteps after her hat-trick last week against DMP.
Yeah, if you watch her, you see Alex hit it, but she spins it at the same time, and it's given Worcester there a helping hand, really, to turn it. In situations like that, you've got to keep straight. Dig your feet in.
Conversion then being lined up.
That one, again, just drifts wide, but 33-15 the scoreline here, 57 minutes on the clock, and Worcester only one try away from the try bonus point. There's Poppy Cleal on the screen, perhaps just reliving that moment in her head. And the referee just having a chat with Marley Packer and asking her to remind her team about the values in the red zone in terms of penalty concession. Zoe Harrison then restarts. Marley Packer hairing after that one with Lottie Clapp. And Clapp does really well to scythe down Lydia Thompson. Thompson, though, wasn't held, manages to get up and away.
She's a big physical winger, isn't she, Lydia Thompson? It's great to see her back in a shirt.
She really is, Lydia Thompson, a fantastic, fantastic player and a fantastic servant to the English game as well. Sarah McKenna, another one of those who has been so, so good for the Red Roses over years and years, as well as Saracens. Carson, though, to Evans.
Great line by Evans.
Brilliant line. Saracens penalty, though. Tackler not rolling away.
Tackler needs to go first.
And this seems to be becoming a little bit of a pattern here this afternoon for both teams, Donna. Just as soon as they score, they give up a penalty or a knock-on in and around their 22, just invite the pressure back onto themselves.
Okay. End of that white line, Joe. End of the white line.
Harrison then puts that one into touch.
What do you reckon?
There's May Campbell.
She's got to double what Kelsey did. Kelsey scored one, she's got to score two. She's got double what Kelsey's got.
You wouldn't put it past May Campbell to try and bag herself another try this afternoon.
She's moving fast.
Yeah. Let's have a look then. There's the driving maul. She's holding on to it. And Fante is there with her. It's motoring forward. It's 5 metres out.
Drop your shoulder. Oh, no, what's an idea?
Lottie Clapp joining her as well in there, and it's creeping up to the line. It's still the same maul, says the referee.
Here we are.
Penalty advantage.
Penalty advantage for a side entry, and it's been flipped out in the end, and it's not May Campbell, but it is Leanne Infante, her first try back in Saracens colours, and a really clever little read there after that maul had sort of pretty much died to death.
Yeah, great little spin there to get that score. Well done, Leanne. Welcome home.
Look at it here then. Worcester did really well. I know they gave up the penalty, but did really well to disrupt it. But then Infante versus Mattison, just looking at it here, she had the awareness, and by the time she'd spun out of that space, there was very little that Katie Mattison could do about that one.
Yeah, I think everyone's switched off because they knew that there was a pen coming. Everyone switched off. Leanne took advantage of that.
She definitely did take advantage of that one. Now can Zoe Harrison take advantage off the tee as well? Yes, she can. Do you ever doubt Zoe Harrison? Superb conversion we hear from the PA here at the stadium. I think that sums it up. That is a very fair call. 5 from 6 from the tee for Zoe Harrison, and we see those fans waving their flags next to the fantastic Saracens Pioneers, and they'll be really pleased and really happy with what they've seen so far from their side. 20 minutes left of the match. Confusion again at the restart, and this time it is a penalty against Saracens, a knock-on and then offside.
Knocked on, offside.
The referee just explains that to both sets of players. We talked about it becoming a bit of a pattern, and it's continuing to be that. Worcester straight back into the 22. In fact, pretty much as close to the try line as they can possibly be from Sarah Nicholas. And they will be hunting after that fourth try here.
Oh, hang on. Paris is on.
There we go, Paris Phillips into the fray.
Let's go, Marley.
Stack queen.
hat-trick last week against DMP. Worcester are going, Worcester are scoring, and they have that fourth
try. Absolutely great try there.
Charlotte Wright Haley it is who's gone over. Donna, as you said, absolutely great try. And again, it seems to be the theme in this match. Really, really clever disguise off of a set play.
Yeah, she had the choice to have Karis Phillips outside of there, but she took it herself, which was a smart move. She saw that gap, she took it.
And under pressure as well, May Campbell was doing absolutely everything in her power to stop her. Just look here, throws that dummy. Marley Packer unable to do anything about it, and May Campbell clinging on for dear life, but not able in the end to stop the flanker. And Worcester, regardless of what happens in this last little under 20 minutes, will come away with something for their efforts this afternoon. Conversion though drifts wide again, so it's 40 points to 20, 6 tries to 4. We're being treated to an absolute try fest so far this afternoon, aren't we?
It's a really good game for women's rugby.
Fantastic game for women's rugby. It's ebbed, it's flowed. And Poppy Cleal then still has 3 minutes left in the bin, let's not forget as well. Worcester then coming away from the restart, something Saracens weren't able to do, and that's what allowed them to score their fourth. McKenna lets it bounce and she's under all sorts of pressure. And Marley Packer tips it on to Mackenzie Carson, and Mackenzie Carson searching for support, but it wasn't there. And in the end, Worcester come away with it. But then Saracens win the penalty for holding on.
Mark's here. So holding on. We're 9-21.
And Harrison then will whack this one as deep into Worcester territory as she can.
End of the white. Guys, end of that white line. End of that
we
white
mentioned
line.
It as well at half time, but we'll mention it again just as the line out is getting set and Grace Moore's made her way onto the field as well.
Guys, stop there.
Make sure to purchase your tickets for the Duel, the next home match here at StoneX Stadium on the 18th of February. Against Harlequins, London's biggest rivalry. It's tickets on saracens.com, £5 for under 16s and £10 for adults, but also an unbelievable opportunity if you purchase your ticket today to come and meet the squad at a training session as well before the match.
You can see here Fee Lewis is on now. She brings a lot of intent and a great pass.
And again, a player that you know very well from Wales as well, Fee Lewis. Line out time though for Saracens with Grace Moore in there as well. It's a bit of a mess, but it's tidied up by Fee McIntosh, and Marley Packer does brilliantly to get that one off the floor to Infante, and Harrison just checks back inside. And you can see it's an absolute fight there on the floor.
Oh,
brilliant, brilliant.
Beautiful
try.
Beautiful try there.
That was sumptuous. And Jess Breach has her second try in Saracens colours, I should say. Donna, you described that one as beautiful. I'm going to go a step further. That was an absolute work of art.
Holly Aitchison with her crossfield kicks is phenomenal.
Well, look at this from Aitchison. Absolutely on the money. Jess Breach collects it and then comes through like a freight train. There's no stopping Jess Breach from that far out. And we saw that from Holly Aitchison against Exeter last week, obviously on the wrong side of the result, but two brilliant, clever kicks through for Lottie Clapp's two tries, and we've seen it again there.
Yeah, Holly's a great player. She's got great vision of the game and she's so calm, collective. I love playing up with her.
She's just one of those players that seems to always have time on the ball and always seems to see things sort of half a second or a second before they actually happen.
Yeah, she's got great vision.
Harrison converts again. And Poppy Cleal is back on for her side as we see Breach there, rounding, grounding, scoring. And Saracens 47, Worcester 20, with 13 minutes to go, and Sharifa Kosolo is on the field as well.
Oh!
That
just karate rolled,
but Campbell manages to get her hands on the ball. A penalty advantage coming as well, and a penalty for Saracens. And Infante's gone quickly, wanting to inject more pace into it. And there's Grace Moore, and Grace Moore only knows one way, and Grace Moore is going forward. Grace Moore still going, brilliant tackle, but she gets the offload away to Infante. Infante is inches away from the line. Have Sarri's got what they need for a second and quick advantage. May Campbell looking for her second, short the call. And yes, they do. It's Grace Moore. She started it there with that break and that offload to Infante. And Saracens luck could hardly keep up there. They've hit the half century and two brilliant tries in as many minutes. Grace Moore there with the try. Donna, another player who has joined this season and has been such a physical presence in this side, whether it's starting or coming off the bench.
Yeah, Grace, you know, she's physical. She's got a lot to learn, but once she's learned that, I think she'll be great.
Plays across the back row as well, Grace Moore, and works for the fantastic Saracens Foundation here as well. Zoe Harrison adds another two to her personal tally for the afternoon.
I'm excited to see Sharifa. She's an excellent back rower. She's only been playing for a short while, and once she knows the game, she's really, really going to do great.
Alex Austerbury described her at the start of the season as really a rough diamond, and you can see there with that take from the restart, just the natural rugby ability.
Oh.
Okay, stop there, four. Okay, you're on now.
Worcester then put boot to ball, and there's plenty of space.
Yeah, that's onside. Really good kick.
Taken well by Harrison. Isla Alejandro is on the field now for Saracens as well. Both sides making wholesale changes.
Don't leave her.
And there's Kosolo again, carrying hard into contact. Could hear you getting excited there, Donna. Kosolo, nearly a fantastic offload, but it just drifted forward. It will be a Worcester scrum. But again, what will really impress Alex Austerbury here is that, yes, his side are ahead, but they're not taking their foot off the gas. They're continuing to press and probe and see what they can do.
And that's why the cup is important, to bring these players up and give them a chance. Coming off the bench is hard, but these players can really come off the bench. It showed last week against Exeter too, but they brought in 10.
Come up. Don't take your
break. Just confirming
off.
Those okay. changes then. Isla Alejandro is onto the field as well, and Mika Gooding coming on for Mackenzie Carson. Jodie Retty as well coming on for May Campbell, so she won't be able to get her second try of the day, but she still has managed to get a try on her 100th appearance for the club. Great angle there of Fee Lewis looking to put the ball in, and there it goes. Saracens looking to get the push on at the scrum, but use it the call. And Worcester do just that and release Paige nice. Farries, and Farries is gone, and Farries a brilliant draw.
It's Deborah.
It's Deborah Wills, formerly of these parts, powers up to 5 metres out from the line. And there's Kershaw as well. So this is the game that just keeps giving in terms of attacking intent from both sides.
Oh, she's run into her shoulder there.
Ooh. penalty then goes against Poppy Cleo. And Donna, I could hear you let out a gasp there.
I think she ran into the shoulder of one of the players.
High tackle
is the call. Wouldn't want to look at that one again in a hurry. But Worcester with the penalty for a high tackle, and they've gone to the corner. We saw what happened when they went there last time. Let's see what happens this time then. Karis Phillips, but it's been overthrown. Saracens chase it up.
The lifters just didn't lift then. I don't think it was overthrown. I just think the lifters are tired.
Well, like we said, it's one of those where, and that's a really good boot down the field from Saracens for Worcester to try and tidy up, that the ball in play time in this game, as that one drifts out on the full, has been absolutely enormous, and it's no surprise that it has taken its toll a little bit on some of the decision making for the players.
On the end of that white line.
Definitely. They must be tired out there. They've been non-stop running around that field. Again, I feel sorry for hookers. They do get the blame for overthrows, but sometimes it could be a lifters or jumpers.
Fee McIntosh then, quick ball off the top. Donna, I'm going to give you a little bit of a cue. In a couple of minutes' time, I'm going to ask you for your player of the match. That's a sumptuous offload to Sydney Gregson, but the ball just evades that final player. Knock-on advantage. Donna, I'll give you a few more minutes to have a think about it, but who's impressed you so far today?
Kelsey Clifford, fellow tight head. She's done amazing today on her 50th. She's really stood up. Like I said, she's only 21 years old. She's got such a long way to go, and she's going to be amazing. She is amazing now, so imagine what she'll be in a year or two.
High praise indeed there for Kelsey Clifford.
Also paid for Worcester. I want to give her a shout out. She, like I said, like the greatest showman, she's got such magic and flair with her. I love it.
Well, a bit of flair there, and Sydney Gregson spots the gap, shows, goes, reaches out, and she's over. Well, you talked about the greatest showman, you talked about the added flair. Sydney Gregson with her second try in as many home games as well, and Saracens putting on a show in this final 10 minutes. Sydney Gregson there, you can see it bursts through, a lovely little hitch kick just to take her away from the final tackler. Brilliant pass from Zoe Harrison, and then Gregson is back. Worcester overcommit slightly with Poppy Cleal on the outside, and there were three fans there who looked very happy with that try from Sydney.
It's good to see the ball going through Saracens' hands. It's, you know, the forward pack are very dominant, but they can also offload.
I think that's the thing that we've seen today that's been so good, and you have to say from both teams actually, has been that offloading ability in contact. It's really, really added to the game as well. And like you said, forwards, backs, all chipping in, all showing what they can do and showing the importance of that handling.
It's also great to watch, great rugby.
It really is great rugby to watch, and
scrum advantage knocked on.
Wills then tried to get her mitt on the ball, just lost it forward. If you've enjoyed what you've watched with us this afternoon at the StoneX, make sure you get your tickets next time. We are here on the 18th of February for the duel. London's biggest rivalry, one of the biggest games of the season here at StoneX Stadium, no doubt at all. Penalty though for Saracens there.
Off feet
at the breakdown, the call from Holly Wood.
Okay, end of the white line, Worcester.
Just under 5 minutes to go here, and Jodie Ressie directly in front of us, just inside the Worcester Warriors half. But that one is stolen at the front by Cara Brinker. She's another player that's had a really good game today alongside Wright Haley in that back row.
Big carry there by Karis Phillips.
Hands away now,
it's good to see the ball in her hand.
I think it's always good from a Worcester perspective to see Karis Phillips with her hands on the ball.
Tackle is not rolled. No, it's fine.
And a break through the middle there from Worcester, and it's Wright Haley again who's away.
That's a great line.
It's a brilliant line. The game might be done for Worcester, but
they can, this is what I said at the start, they've got the heart and passion for it.
They really do. The character coming through in everything that the Warriors have done this afternoon.
Release. No, you get released, leave it.
And still probing, shoot, pressing, looking for the fifth try of the afternoon.
No, hand away! Hand away, White!
It's come away into Saracen's hands, and Moore tipped that one on to Cleal. And Fante looking for the ball, and Zoe Harrison spins that one to Aitchison, and Aitchison
somewhere outside there.
Outside Nyla. Alejandra has broken free. Jess Breach trying to stay in support. Breach thought she was away. Paige Farries, brilliant tackle to force the knock on. Breach for a second there, thought she was in for her second of the afternoon, but Paige Farries, we've seen what she can do in attack this afternoon, that's what she can give you in defence as well. Look at this replay, Isla Alejandro, brilliant, brilliant break from the substitute. Breach trying so hard to stay in the supporting line, and Farries just hounding her and probing her and forcing her to take the line she wanted to. Right then, Donna, it's a scrum for Worcester, deep in their 22. There's 2 minutes to go. I think this is a perfect time to ask you, who are you going to give the player of the match to this afternoon?
Bind!
Like I said, Paige is really shunning this game. And
come up.
Sorry there.
Flat back, square shoulders, not getting that stability before the set.
Okay. Yeah, so a big shout out to Paige, but this player who I'm choosing, she does all the dog work, and she scored two tries today, so... Louise McMillan.
Louise McMillan, your player of the match. Player of the match against Wasps earlier in the season as well. On a bit of a hot streak at the moment in terms of appearing in the Premier 15's team of the week as well.
She's a great sign-in for us. I've said it earlier. She's really good, and she's a really good positive person to be around as well.
She just, like you said, she just seems like a really bubbly, bubbly character. Penalty advantage for Saracens at the scrum. Let's see what happens here then. Harrison to Aitchison. Can Saracens finish with another final flourish here? De Solo.
Go on, Sharif.
Wrapped up well, but she gets the ball away to Poppy Cleal, and there's no stopping Poppy Cleal from that distance. Saracens will go beyond 60 points. They will get their ninth try, and Poppy Cleal, I suppose, will be happy with that and redeeming herself for that yellow card earlier in the match. Have a look at this one then. Casolo with a brilliant break, offloaded to Cleal. And as much as Cara Brinker tried there, you just don't stop a player with the power of Poppy Cleal that close to the line.
Sharif there pumping her legs to break that tackle. You know, she's going to be great.
So this will be the final act of the game then. Can Zoe Harrison finish with a flourish off the tee? Not quite, it hits the post from Harrison, but that is full time here at StoneX Stadium. It's Saracens 64, Worcester Warriors 20. 10 tries for the hosts, 4 tries for the Warriors, so they will take a try bonus point home with them. Harrison laughing there with some people on screen, perhaps giving her a little bit of stick about the post there. But Donna, overall, a really, really impressive performance from Saracens, and one that they needed, really, in terms of that attacking prowess.
Yeah, I think we've reloaded and we've gone again. Some little errors there, but nothing we can't clear out. I want a big shout out to Worcester. They've played well today, and they've stood up and had the heart and carried on fighting. So fair play to them.
I think, as you mentioned there, Worcester did not give in at all. Kept going, kept doing what they could do. And deservedly coming away with four tries and a bonus point to take back down the M5 with them. And as Sweet Caroline blares out around the ground and the players shake hands and congratulate each other on a job well done, let's take a look at some of the standout scores. Well, here was this first Paige Farries try in the first half. Just saw the space, put her head down, powered through for a brilliant, brilliant try for her side, one that got them on the board. And there she was grounding it, but then this one from Saracens, the dink over the top, the gather from Aitchison, and then the pass. This was just a special, special score.
That's a very good tackle though. That's a textbook tackle there.
It was a great tackle, but then this pass was something special from Harrison, and Cleal seeing Grant on her outside, doing what she needed to do, releasing the play, and the winger went in and went round in the end. Another angle here on that sumptuous, sumptuous pass from Zoe Harrison. And then this one as well, still in the first half here, Georgia Evans pumping the legs, getting the hands free, away to Louise McMillan. Brilliant turn of pace from the second row, and she was in for the first of her two tries in a player of the match performance. Worcester though deservedly got their bonus point, and this was really clever then from Wright Haley, just doing Marley Packer with the eyes and then having that power to get herself over the line despite the best efforts of May Campbell.
Yeah, that was great vision there.
And we'll finish for now with this one, the Jess Breach try. That kick from Holly Aitchison is bang on the money. That was absolutely delicious.
Absolutely, stop it.
Just look here at this reverse angle. Just the weight on the ball and the timing actually from Breach as well to clock onto that one was absolutely fantastic.
She does them for fun at training, crossfield kicks.
And there is the Saracens team on screen going through their final messages with Alex Austerbury. He'll be really pleased with that one. Hands in the middle. And just before we speak to the winning director of rugby and Louise McMillan as player of the match, we will just take a few moments here to say thank you again to our fantastic partners here at Saracens.
Unprecedented market force is causing a shift in direction. There may be some long-term opportunity if traders can see through the noise.
Master the market forces with City Index. Trade with confidence.
Final
flourish from Saracens, a real class.
Unprecedented market force is causing a shift in direction. There may be some long-term opportunity if traders can see through the noise.
Master the market forces with City Index. Trade with confidence.
Alex, 10 tries in all. Really, really good attacking display from your side today. What are your initial thoughts on that one?
Yeah, real pleased with some of the elements of it. You know, some of the attacking play was very good. We created a lot of opportunities. Some of them we missed, and we talked about half-time, making sure the speed of support and that energy to get on line breaks. And we saw some real, like, intelligent ways to break down defences. And at times, that was brilliant. And at times, we made, you know, made it hard for ourselves with errors and not making correct decisions around just understanding what was available. But ultimately, yeah, it's a good bounce back performance. A little bit disappointed with the nature of the tries we conceded. I thought they were a little bit kind of soft, and it came from times when we had pressure. We released that pressure through an error, and then we got punished, and we've got to learn pretty quickly from that. You know, if we're going to make an error, we can't then back it up with an error or a score, because that just really swings momentum. And we saw, you know, the game got tight at parts, and you just want to keep on top when you're on top, because it's hard to earn it, and if you give it away too easily, it's going to be difficult to get it back.
Like you said, it is hard to stay on top, but your side did that throughout, and a couple of absolutely fantastic tries. That Kareem Grant try in the first half, that Jess Breach one with that little kick in the second half. But then we also saw what your forwards can do today with some of their handling as well.
Yeah, I mean, the game is a balance, isn't it? It's making sure you've got dominant platforms, which the forwards, you know, set you. And then it's how, as the backs, can we come alive? Lewis and JT doing a lot of work with the players on how we can create different pitches, different opportunities, and execute against them. And I think the variety of the scores is pleasing. And it's just making sure that at the right times we have the right balance, and when opportunity arises, we execute against it. So it's good, but there's still a lot of work for us to do to make sure we consistently at the standards that we want. But it's a good step forward today.
And two of your players hitting those milestones, we talked about that first up, and a try for the pair of them as well. Fantastic for them. But Louise McMillan as well was Donna's player of the match up in commentary. Two tries for her, and seems to have settled into life in a Saracens shirt like a duck to water.
Yeah, I mean, we're really happy with how she's going. And again, we knew she had real quality bringing her into the group. But as I keep saying, the exciting thing around these players is where can they get to? Incredibly industrious. You know, she's come in, learnt roles, asked a few challenges to get up to speed quite quickly on things, and she's there in terms of that. So it's really good to see her hard work paying off. But more, you know, more importantly, from my point of view, it's where she can go and where that in turn will take the team's game. So yeah, fair credit to Lou. But again, I want it to be, you know, I want it to go better for me. I want her to keep on improving and creep, you know, maximising her potential, and that's what we talked about. How can we be the best version of ourselves? And today was a good step for everyone. Another good performance from Lou, but let's chase better.
Alex, brilliant. Thank you very much for your time. I'll embarrass Louise now, because she was standing next to you whilst you were talking about her, and bring her into shot. Louise, congratulations. Really good performance from the squad. Another really good performance from yourself. And you said to me after that DMP game, you've been getting a fair amount of stick for not diving when you go over the try line. Ended up doing it twice today.
Yeah, no, I definitely need to improve my technique. But yeah, after last week, we were super disappointed. And we knew how much this game, how special it was for me and for Kelsey. So I think we brought that right from the start, just bringing that energy for them, because it is such a special day. I don't know how they got to that many caps, and they're still both so young, but it's pretty cool to play alongside them.
Talk about that as well then. Kelsey didn't waste any time at all getting over the line, just a couple of minutes on the clock. For you as a group, after that extra performance last week, how important was it to get that fast start today?
Oh yeah, completely. Kelsey is one of the hardest working props I've ever met, so I think we're all absolutely buzzed when she got that. And then May's an absolute animal around the park. Like, I've never seen anyone chop so low as she does, but yeah, we all wanted to do it for them today.
Let's just talk a little bit about your tries as well. The first one, really nice interplay off the back of the penalty, and then just seeing the space and going over where the gap was.
Yeah, for me, I think it maybe took me a few games to get into working alongside the other girls, because there's so much talent in this squad. So I think I'm now starting to find my place and know who to run off of and who's going to make those little line breaks. So maybe sometimes a bit cheeky, but yeah, helpful to run off of them.
And that second one then, the break and then the offload from Georgia Evans. Donna was waxing lyrical in commentary about your turn of pace as well, as you galloped away over for that try. Yeah, you've got a massive smile on your face every single time you're on the field. How much are you enjoying it?
That's funny, because all I could hear was little Kelsey's voice behind me, like, Louise, Louise! But it turns out there was actually somebody chasing me down. But I was like, Kelsey, I'm not giving you this ball. But she was actually just trying to tell me there was someone behind me. So she told me that at halftime. I was like, okay, sorry, Kelsey. I just thought you were just looking for an inside ball that I wasn't going to give. But yeah, no, all good.
But how much are you enjoying it in a Saracen shirt, though? Because, as I said, you seem to have a smile on your face whenever I see you, whether it's at training or on the field as well.
Yeah, I feel like I'm the poster child for quit your corporate job and come and fulfil your dream. But no, I'm the most grateful person in the world right now. Scotland have given me this chance. Saris have accepted me with open arms. So, I'm in the dream, living my dream.
Brilliant. Well, Louise, living the dream, as you said. Donna's player of the match today up in commentary. Congratulations. I'll let you go and celebrate with the rest of the team.
Thank you so much.
And well, there you have it. 14 tries in all, 10 for Saracens, 4 for Worcester. A brilliant, brilliant occasion here at StoneX Stadium. Fun for all the family. a brilliant day out, and as we said in commentary, next time we are back here is the duel on the 18th of February against Harlequins. It's a 2 p.m. kickoff. Tickets are on sale at saracens.com for just £10. Hospitality opportunities as well, some unbelievable hospitality opportunities on the website as well. And if you've enjoyed what you've seen today, get yourself down here. Buy your tickets today if you haven't. There's a chance to meet the players at the training ground for those who do purchase their tickets by midnight tonight. And there's a couple of players who want to remind you about why you should come next time we're here. Thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you on the 18th.
Are you doing anything on the 18th of February?
Yeah, I am actually.
What are you doing?
The duel, Saracens v Harlequins.
Where is that?
StoneX Stadium.
That's exciting.
See you there.
Gone up the blind side, Connie Powell goes straight over the tackler. Irwin, the pick and go, Green right on her shoulder, gives it short to Vicky Irwin again. Watts spreading the play, Abby Dow coming in, great step from Abby Dow. What a dummy from Scott, racing under the stick! Decent chance here for Bristol Bears for the try that'll take them to the playoffs! Robinson goes, Detivo, one-on-one to score! On her outside, steps again, magical from Helena Rowland. Vivas now, short to Molly Packer, runs up against Beckett, spins, goes again, brilliant from Packer. They are the 2022 Allianz Premier 15's champions.